distinguished members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, on the occasion of the 86th anniversary of the Indian Air Force, I extend my warm wishes to all of you. As you have seen in the documentary just now, the Indian Air Force has transformed into a potent aerospace power, and its operational preparedness is of the highest order. IAF's growth is a recognition of the inevitable rise of air power as a dominant and all-pervasive component of modern warfare. Professionalism and excellence and pioneering spirit remain our guiding principles for future growth. As we prepare to celebrate our 86th anniversary on 8th October, it is great pride that we appreciate our brave air warriors who have displayed courage and professionalism and ensured successful completion of all missions, no matter how daunting the conditions. We also pay tribute to our brave martyrs, amongst them Corporal Jyoti Prakash Nirala, who was awarded the highest peacetime gallantry award of Ashok Chakra. In the past few years, the geopolitical environment has been rapidly changing, and uncertainties have created numerous challenges to national security. IAF is ever prepared to meet any contingency that challenges the defense of our country. In the years gone by, IAF has continued to grow from strength to strength and achieved a number of operational milestones. IAF is proud of its achievement in the past 86 years. Our focus, however, is to continue to strengthen Indian air power for the future. Towards this, the IAF believes in periodic acquisitions, upgradation and modernization of its inventory. IAF is looking at inducting new generation combat aircraft and precision weapons that will provide it with the capability to deter a nation's enemy. IAF roadmap for modernization is as per its long-term integrated perspective plan. Several plans are in progress to bolster the strength of the fighter fleet. The mid-life upgradation of the Mirage 2000, MiG-29 and the Jaguar fleet is in progress. Acquisition of the Rafale and the S-400 will further enhance our operational capability to counter the shortfall of our depleting numbers. The LCA Tejas, since its induction, has successfully participated in the Republic Day flypast. The aircraft took part in exercise Gagan Shakti 18, where the squadron maintained a high rate of serviceability and achieved exceptional results in air-to-ground bombing, including the firing of two laser-guided bombs. Recently, air-to-air refueling has been undertaken by the LCA for the first time, as you've seen in the promo. In April this year, IAF conducted the largest ever exercise Gagan Shakti 2018 with the aim to practice real-time coordination and deployment of forces, employment of air power in realistic short, intense battle scenario in conjunction with the Indian Army and the Indian Navy. Exercise aptly showcased the operational capability and readiness of the IAF. Operation, maintenance and administration activities are carried out by each and every person of the IAF. It ensured success of the exercise. IAF remains committed to indigenous development of high technology military hardware in consonance with Make in India initiative of the Honorable Prime Minister. Aim is to reduce dependence on foreign or OEMs and achieve self-reliance. It has been the endeavor of the IAF to reach out and engage with Indian private industries to enhance self-reliance efforts. This year, we have already conducted indigenization events at Visakhapatnam, Hyderabad and Chennai as a part of DEF Expo 2018 and recently on 27th July 18 at New Delhi. The aim of this seminar was to enhance awareness amongst Indian industry about indigenization requirements of the IAF, indigenization procedures, vendor registration procedure, airworthiness certification and quality assurance requirements associated with the indigenization of airborne products. To promote indigenization, the IAF has created nodal technical centers at all base repair depots and equipment depots to give impetus to innovation and their successful execution. Concerted efforts by PRDs have led to indigenization of more than 47,000 lines of spares. 95% of the components that go into the depot level repairs of aircraft in the base repair depot is indigenous. The Avro replacement aircraft and closing weapon systems will be manufactured in India through the Buy and Make group. To promote and enthuse participation of the sharpest technical minds and untapped innovative potential in emerging new technological domains, today Indian Air Force is launching a competition to develop and design drones to operate as a swarm and convey relief material to stranded citizens in disaster-hit regions. The competition is named the Baba Meher Singh Competition in honor of one of the Indian Air Force's highly decorated officer of World War II, Air Commodore, that is Baba Meher Singh, distinguished as DSO MBC. Competition is thrown open to all Indian citizens, academic institutions and entities. IAF would give 10 lakh prize to the winner and 10 crores to each selected team toward development, followed by a sizable co-production order of 100 crores. All further details are available in the Indian Air Force website. I hope to see maximum participation towards fruitful, innovative solution. In the last 1 year, you have seen in the promo film, Indian Air Force has been actively involved in providing rescue and relief to cyclone-affected and landslide-affected areas in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Tripura, Nagaland, Himachal Pradesh and Karnataka. I have provided timely assistance in fighting forest fires in Theni, Katra, Pathankot, Kasauli and even here in Delhi. It required flying helicopters in the most challenging conditions and terrain in the world. In addition, airlifting of relief material to Myanmar, firefighting at an Indian merchant ship, Kazibank of pilgrims for Kailash Mansarovar and Amarnath Yatra were also taken out. Today, as we speak, two aircraft, one C-130 and C-17, have gone to Indonesia to provide relief for the earthquake and the tsunami. In addition to HADR operations, we have further expanded our participation in bilateral and multilateral exercises with air forces of friendly foreign countries such as Australia, Russia, Israel, Singapore, Malaysia, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh and Nepal, demonstrating to the world our growing strategic reach and power projection capabilities. Today, we are recognized as a professional air force and many air forces of the world have asked to train with us. Through these exercises in other nations, we learn the best tactics and keep abreast of the latest in military aviation. Exercise Avya Indra is a biennial Air Force level exercise conducted every alternate year with Russia. One phase has been completed in Lipetsk, Russia from 17 to 28 September 18, where air and ground crew of Indian Air Force operated Russian equipment with the Russian Air Force. Subsequently, the next phase, the Russian Air Force, air and ground crew would operate IAF equipment at Jodhpur in December 2018. As both countries operate similar equipment, the exercise provides a great opportunity to learn best practices from each other. Losses during peacetime are always a cause of concern. Indian Air Force is making concerted efforts to reduce the accidents and preserve our flying assets. We have inducted state-of-the-art flight simulators for training of air crew, exposing them to realistic operational environment without endangering flight safety. Procurement of AVN radar, that is bird detection and monitoring radar, is a process which will strengthen our bird hazard control measures. Sharing of aerospace safety information between the Indian Air Force, Army, Indian Navy, Coast Guard, HAL and DGQA has been introduced for better and faster trend analysis of failures and speedy implementation of remedial measures. A memorandum of understanding has been signed for sharing of aerospace safety information with Russia, and efforts are on to have similar MOUs with other countries for enhanced sharing of information on common operating fleets. I believe that though the machine is important, the true strength of any organization lies with the man behind the machine. Towards further nurturing this resource and ensuring gender parity with its personnel, IAF has proudly extended the option of converting permanent commission from short service commission to both men and women officers prospectively in all branches, including the flying branch. In the past 1 year, our air warriors have scaled great heights of success in the field of sports as well as adventure, as you have just seen in the promo film. Performance displayed by our young air warriors in various sporting events like Commonwealth, International Shooting Federation, World Cup and Asian Games have been commendable. Nation as a whole and Indian Air Force in particular is extremely proud of their achievements. Towards improved induction, the IAF this year commenced an online examination for recruitment of airmen and IAF with the intention to facilitate youth from all over the country to appear for the exam from a center close to their place of residence. On this occasion, we take this opportunity to pay tribute to our veterans and acknowledge their outstanding contribution. It is their vision and tenacity of purpose that nurtured a fledgling Air Force along the path of progress that you see today. We are forever indebted to our pioneers who were unrelenting in the face of tremendous hardship during the formative years of the Indian Air Force. We assure them that we will continue to strive for excellence and ensure success in every mission that we undertake, keeping in line with the values and ethos that we have inherited from them. The Indian Air Force has the support and trust of the nation. We are grateful for it. I am confident that our collective capacity to achieve excellence and our commitment will take the IAF and the nation to greater heights. On behalf of all Air Warriors, I express my gratitude to the Ministry of Defence and the Government of India for their support toward the modernization of the Air Force. I take this opportunity to publicly pledge our resolve in guarding the nation's skies and opposing our motto, "Touch the sky with glory." Thank you and Jai Hind.